Hello everyone, my name is Srishti Jayant Deshmukh. I am trying to utilize this personal space of mine to share with you my resources for preparation. The main motive behind this short clip is to tell you the book list for sociology, optional. So I hope that it adds value to your preparation and you are able to gain something and benefit from it. To begin with, have a look at my mark sheet. I have scored 312 marks in sociology this year, which is decent giving the scores. We will divide this entire clip into two parts of paper 1 and paper 2. So I will tell you the books, and along with that I will also tell you the different chapters that I referred to from that specific book. Because in the optional, we rarely read the entire book. We use it for reference. So along with it, I will also tell you the chapters. The most important document for the preparation of sociology optional is your syllabus. Very nicely, concisely, each and aspect of the topic is given. So please get a copy of the syllabus printed and keep it with you whenever you are studying. I also tried to make a mind map of the entire syllabus so that whatever I am studying related to it, I can add up to the specific point which is there in the syllabus. Apart from that, I also tried to maintain individual folders or files for each and every chapter so that when I made notes out of it, I added the same into the specific folder. It will help you in organizing your notes and keeping all of them together for the purpose of revision. After syllabus, another source which is very basic and important for your preparation are the NCERTs. Try and glance through and read completely the NCERTs of sociology. They will give you a basic idea whether or not you like the subject and whether or not you find it interesting. After the NCERTs, you can pick up the material of IGNU, both of BA and MA level. The material of IGNU at BA and MA level will help you to get a good information about the different topics in the syllabus. Each and every topics are explained in a very detailed manner. In paper 1, there is one basic thing about sociological thinkers. I took this help from Coursera.com. Here you will find a video by a professor who's from Netherlands. So you can go refer to that video. They have a set of good videos of 4 to 5 and entire thinkers, for example, Emile Durkheim, Karl Marx and Max Weber have been covered really well by him. So you can watch his videos there. If I am to talk about the chapters 1, 2, 3 and 4 of paper 1, I refer to the resources of Sleepy Classes. The Sleepy Classes is a YouTube channel where very nicely and concisely they have made notes from different sources, and especially for the chapters, as I told you, 1, 2, 3, 4, you can refer to those videos and I found it really helpful. After this basic source that we have seen, if you have to raise the level up of your preparation, the book Haralambos and Healed, the small one with orange cover, will help you to cover major part of the syllabus. In the book Haralambos and Healed, you can refer to all the chapters starting from 1 to 8. Those chapters will take you through the entire syllabus of paper 1 and cover the topics of family, poverty, education, work and leisure, power and politics, and social stratification, etc. Also, chapter 11, that is religion, that also you can cover from this book Haralambos and Healed. Coming to the next book, Haralambos and Healed, the bigger one, which is the blue one, Haralambos and Holborn. So this book by Collins Publication, here the chapter on methodology is given in a very detailed manner. So if you can get hold of the chapter of methodology, that will be really good. In any case, if you want to deepen your understanding of the sociological thinkers, there's one more resource that you can refer to, and that is the book Sociological Theory by George Ritzer. From that, I covered three basic and important thinkers, that is Karl Marx, Max Weber, and Emile Durkheim. Other perspectives of ethno-methodology, etc. are also given there. you can just refer to it and check out what you think is not important and make notes thoroughly out of it. The last thing for paper 1 that I will say is a resource that has everything in one place, and that is the book Essential Sociology by Nitin Sangwan. This book is a new one, and when I found out about this book, I read it, I found that everything was given at one place. So if you have any missing puzzle pieces of your preparation, you can refer to this book and cover those topics. They are given very nicely. At the end, there are also some questions given at the end of each chapter. You can also try and solving those questions while you read and learn. Also, the Oxford Dictionary on Sociology is that one-stop source where if any term you are unable to understand at any moment of your preparation, you can just go through it and try and understand the meaning given in the dictionary. Some of the words or keywords are explained really well, and you can directly write that and use those words in your answers. So here we covered the resources for paper 1. Moving on to paper 2. Which is much more dynamic, and let us find out what resources helped me. So firstly, I referred to the book Essential Sociology by Nitin Sangwan. As I said, it has everything at one place. So whatever topics that you feel, read from it, try and learn the definitions, and the examples are also, which are given in this book, are also really good. Another basic book for paper 2, which you can start with, is The Indian Sociological Thought by B.K. Nagla. Here, the different Indian thinkers like Louis Dumont, André Bethe, M.N. Srinivas have been explained really well. Especially the concept of Yogendra Singh has been beautifully explained with a table. So you can refer to this book and get a clear picture of what the Indian thinkers have comprehended and what views they have given. Apart from this book, there's a book by Nadeem Hasnain. Now this I found online, but this one is Indian Society and Culture and not on tribes. So please find out this book. I'll try and give the link in the description below. So this book is really good for the chapters like caste, the caste system, the caste mobility, and the concepts around it have been explained really well here. So you can refer to this book. Moving on to the chapter on agrarian transformation and rural sociology, the book by S.L. Doshi and P.C. Jain really helped me. There the chapters on agrarian part have been covered really well. Land tenure system and the land reforms have been explained nicely. Another thing in this book is the concepts like Sanskritization and mobility have been really well defined. So you can use this book for those parts of paper 2. Another resource is the Handbook of Indian Sociology by Veena Das. Now, you don't have to read the entire book, but some of the chapters, like the one by Dipankar Gupta, by Satish Deshpande, and others on chapters on family and informal sector are really good. So you can get hold of these chapters and make notes out of it. One good resource that I found for Sociology Paper 2 during the course of my preparation are the videos and material of EPG Pathshala. The EPG Pathshala provides you notes for different topics at one single place, and they have been prepared by respected faculties, so it is really authentic and can be directly used in the answers. So along with the books and resources that I've mentioned, I also rigorously tried to practice writing answers, and the answers were initially I was not able to perform really good, but I kept writing and got my answers corrected at online forums. I posted some of my answers on IS Baba as well. Then I took a test series at Sleepy Classes, and there I wrote about 4 to 5 tests. So sir really analyzed my copy well and told me where I was lacking. And after my prelims, I took a test series at Vision IS, where I wrote about 5 to 6 tests. And it was there that the final touches to my answers were given, and I found out where to add more and how to adjust my answers. So I'll say the final touch was there. So finally, I'll say
that after you have referred to and understood the books, please also start writing answers from, together itself, because when we write answers, we are able to comprehend the things in a better manner, and it will also help in getting us good marks.
So you just saw the answer copies of mine of Sociology. I will say that beyond the book list and the resources, the answer writing is also really important, because finally it's the answers which will help you to comprehend the subject and also will fetch you marks in the exam. So try and use flowcharts in your answers. Try and express yourself clearly. Start through definitions. For this, you can watch two videos that I watched. The first one is an explanation by Smriti ma'am of Vision IAS for Sociology optional. And secondly, you can also go through the frameworks video of Sleepy Classes. These two really helped me when I was starting the answer writing part of my optional. In the further time, I would also like to share with you the mental preparation for this grueling journey of UPSC. So thank you so much, and all the very best to you.